So if you want to have Sue tune your tank, it's actually very simple, and there's a number of products out there on the market that will allow you to use a paintball container, cylinder, whatever you want to call it, like I did, or you can use a regular standard industrial company sized CO2 tank. They are a little bit more expensive, so it's just going to depend on how much money you want to spend. But basically for me, I spent $60 on the regulator, I spent another $17 on the adapter to use the paintball tank, and I spent another $20 on the paintball tank. So that gives you a total of, bing, right there. That's how much it cost me. You know, it's a good price, and it's fair. Because if I were to buy, you know, a really fancy regulator, a really fancy CO2 tank, like an industrial size, and all this extra stuff, it would have cost a lot more, like upwards of $500, $600. And the things I'm talking about are like, you know, the standard industrial size tank, the huge fancy regulator, the fancy diffuser, the like a little reactor type thing, all these extra things that you really don't need, but they sell them in order for you to, you know, put CO2 in your tank. But most of them are really not needed. But you can go that route if you have the money. You know, I do have the money to buy something like that, but I don't want to because it's not necessary. You know, there are a lot of people out there that tell me, you know, why don't you buy this? Why don't you buy that? Why don't you have this filter? Why don't you have that filter? And it basically comes down to, well, it's not worth it. It's not worth spending $300 on a huge wet dry filter when all I need is the smaller or the smallest one, you know. It's not worth it buying a $100 heating system for my tank when, you know, all I need is that little guy in the corner to do it. Some of the things are just not worth it. That's why I don't buy them. So for those of you out there that want CO2 in your tank, you don't have to spend a whole bunch of money in order to do it. And those fancy things really that you can use to put CO2 in your tank really don't differ from the cheaper ones. It's practically the same things. And to me, the cheap ones are actually still pretty good quality. Like the regulator made by Aquatech is very good quality. It's made well. It's made out of solid brass. I mean, it's just, it's really well machined and well put together. The adapter, same thing. It's made very well. It's, you know, it holds up to everything. It's strong. I haven't had any issues with it. And the CO2 tank, same thing. I mean, everything is perfectly fine. So you don't need to go that route and spend a lot of money on, you know, this type of system. So I wanted to just make things clear in this video so that people out there that want CO2 in their tank, you know, don't, you know, continue to think like I did when I was first researching CO2, that it's just going to be insanely too expensive, and instead they go the DIY route with the yeast bottle and the sugar and stuff and things like that, which I did for a little bit, you know. But it did get quite irritating because I had to replace it so often, and it was messy. It was hard to replace, and I would always have CO2 leaks because the part where the airline tubing goes into the top, you know, when you drill the hole in the little cap on top of the bottle and you stuff the airline tubing through that, I would always have leaks through that. You could smell it coming out of the little cracks. So it's a lot harder, you know. It's a lot harder to do the DIY route, and it's just not as fun either, because it totally takes the fun out of it when you're constantly having to change things and do maintenance on your CO2 system. With this, you know, you plug in the solenoid, you make sure that your CO2 tank is filled up all the way, and you hook up the airline tubing into a ceramic diffuser or a bubble wall, whatever you want to use to diffuse it. Preferably a ceramic disc diffuser is best. And you adjust the little needle valve thing, and there you go, you're done. And it lasts for about 6 months or so, depends on how much you use. You don't need to have it run full blast, you know, 24/7. But just, you know, leave it on enough so that there's a nice steady stream of bubbles. And, you know, you'll be good to go, and your plants will have CO2. Now, along with CO2 and along with the good substrate for a planted aquarium, you really have to make sure your lighting is correct, too. And as some of you have already said in the comments, my lighting really isn't the best. It's actually pretty poor compared to a nice planted tank, you know, compared to what a nice planted tank would have. So like I told the person that told me or commented on my other video, I will be in fact buying a higher quality lighting system that's about 75 watts. And usually with a planted tank, you want to do 1 or 2 watts per gallon. So my tank is 50 gallon tall, and if I have a 70 watt lighting system, that should be sufficient, because the plants I have in here really aren't light hungry. You know, they grow with the littlest amount of light, even with these. So That lighting system should be perfect, and I'll be getting that soon, hopefully within the next couple of weeks. And of course, I'll make a video about that so I can show you guys my new lighting system and everything. And also, I've already picked out the one that I'm going to buy, and I'll tell you this, it's not that expensive. It's around 120 bucks compared to other ones that are much more expensive. So once I get it and once I'm able to make a video about it, about me installing it and everything, I'll definitely let you know where you can get it. And I'll definitely let you know how much it, well, I already did let you know how much it costs. But I'll let you know where you can get it and how good it works for my tank, so you'll know if it'll work good for your tank. So thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it. I hope I've cleared things up for you guys about CO2 in an aquarium. If I haven't and you still have a question, feel free to send me a question on YouTube, or you can email me at, or send me an email to jacobtv@yahoo.com. So thanks for watching. I really appreciate it, and I will see you guys next time.